This is Cook Your Ass Off, where incredible cooking and healthy food fight to coexist.
Everything I learned in culinary school has just gone out the window.
Each week, three chefs will compete to help one desperate individual shape up their bad eating habits.
I just need a little help, a little push.
The chef's mission is to remake America's favorite junk food.
Grilled cheese salad.
Pizza.
Fried chicken.
Cheesy
potato skin.
Gotcha.
One unhealthy meal at a time.
The fast food, it's going to kill him.
The chefs will be judged by a panel of experts led by nutritionist Keri Glassman.
He has hypertension, he has high cholesterol. That is how much sodium he should be getting in a day.
I'm Chef Richard Blaise, and I know what it feels like to fight to get your health back. I lost 50 pounds by changing the way I eat and cook food, and that's what this competition is all about. $50,000 is on the line.
Ah! Wow.
Get ready to cook your ass off. Our chefs this week, Chef Ariane Duarte.
Growing up in a big Italian family, food brought us together. I kind of grew up living to eat, not eating to live.
When I became a mom, I realized I needed to set a better example for my children. So I decided to get healthy once and for all.
I bring to the table healthy food, but keeping it so flavorful. And that's why I'm confident that I'm a great chef.
Our next chef is Chef Michael Scipione.
I'm known as Philadelphia's fitness guru with owning both a health club and a private healthy chef catering service.
When I was a kid, I wanted to put some more muscle on, so I decided to get myself in shape and teach myself how to eat the right foods for my body.
I could teach anyone how to get on the right track, whether it's with exercise or whether it is with nutrition. I was meant to be here today.
And our third chef today is Chef Gina Keatley.
I'm very competitive and I can be very intense, but I'm truly committed to making significant change. I'm a trained chef and dietitian and I have a private practice. People do this a lot where they put on a happy smile and say everything's okay, but the reality is that people are dying. It's a slow suicide and it's my responsibility to save them.
Chef Ariane, Chef Michael, Chef Gina, welcome. Today you're here for Meg Shankman. Meg's a nature enthusiast and a veteran vegetarian. Though this sounds like a recipe for a healthy lifestyle, Meg has been struggling with her weight and health for the last 10 years. Pay close attention to her story, because in order to win today, one of you will have to prove that you're the best chef to get Meg's diet back on track.
My name is Meg Shankman. I'm a homemaker. I have a 12-year-old son.
Have a good day.
You too.
I used to live a very active lifestyle, but that all came crashing down when I contracted Lyme disease about 10 years ago.
It affected my sleep, vision, hearing. I became very lethargic, so I gained a lot of weight. I have been on a medical diet, but it was very restrictive. I didn't know how to spice it up and make it appealing. I would like to learn a few recipes that are really quick that would serve myself and my family. We're looking to make a change.
So chefs, Meg is going to be joining us as a judge today, and we'll taste your food along with our experts, Chef Nate Appleman and nutritionist Keri Glassman. Whoever wins today is going to mentor Meg on her journey to an exciting new world of healthy eating. The winner will also move forward to the semifinals of our Cook Your Ass Off tournament and earn the chance to win $50,000. Chefs, we have three rounds to get to. Our first round is simply called the snack attack. Today, Meg's snack that you're going to tackle is Indian samosas. They're basically fried dumplings stuffed with potatoes and vegetables, really crunchy and packed with loads of flavor.
I'm like, wow, I do not expect Indian samosa. That's something I don't think of as a snack.
So, Keri, let's let the chefs know what might not be so great about this snack.
The samosas that Meg is eating, they're basically fried, refined carbohydrates. Meg suffers from Lyme disease, which causes inflammation in the body. The samosas are pro-inflammatory, so we really need to get away from all of the refined carbohydrates that she's been eating.
All right, so chefs, your goal is to create a healthier alternative that will let Meg forget about this dish right here. We're giving you a whole 20 minutes, and you'll have access to our healthy ingredient pantry. The panel will be judging you on taste, creativity, and of course, nutrition. No one's going home at the end of this round. But the winner will gain an advantage for the second round, and trust me, you don't want to miss out on that advantage. All right, chefs, go cook your ass off.
See you at 20.
We're gonna have some fire in there today. I can feel it.
I want to stay as close as possible to the Indian samosa.
It's her favorite snack, so let's just take out the, you know, the unhealthy stuff and just implement the healthier ingredients.
So I'm making a baked Indian samosa wonton dumpling.
I grab the eggplant and the zucchini and white beans. They're all staples in Indian dishes. I start to saute some vegetables. That's gonna go inside my wonton wrapper.
I'm a little worried for Chef Michael, though. I feel like he's just going to recreate a samosa, but have it baked instead of fried. And I'm not sure that's as inspired as what we're looking for here.
Oh gosh. So this Indian samosa that I'm creating, it just replicates who I am. It's clean, it's simple. So today I'm gonna make an Indian-inspired samosa quesadilla, and I'm gonna fill it with vegetables. I'm thinking about nutrition in the way I think a mom and a home cook does.
Meg is a vegetarian, but that doesn't mean she's healthy. And I want to give her inspiration and idea that she can do this. I'm thinking we have to do something really fast and really simple so that Meg can replicate that. So I really think sort of a bruschetta of chickpea, green peas, and potato is a nice take on a samosa that she can do. It's familiar, but it's a new twist on it. And it's really packed with nutrients.
Gina's using peas, chickpeas, and potatoes and bread. That's a lot of carbs all together in a snack. We'll see. We'll see how it works out.
Now I'm making the filling for my tart, and I'm going to substitute cauliflower for potato because cauliflower is just as satisfying and so much healthier. I'm also going to use some other vegetables, the peas and the carrots. I'm going to keep those Indian spices. I want to make sure I keep all those flavors that Meg loves. So I'm keeping it pretty traditional.
A lot of people don't like exotic spices, but you're already there. You like that. So I think this is going to work to your advantage because you can just channel that into something a little more helpful.
Chefs, 10 minutes left. It's going to disappear like that.
A little crazy.
With my nutritional background, I'm really going to cook food for Meg that is really going to benefit her health and control her Lyme disease. So I'm making up a chutney for my wontons with mango and pomegranates and a little cayenne pepper. Cayenne pepper actually helps stop inflammation. Cinnamon, as you know, will help fight inflammation. My nutritional knowledge, I think, is going to get me that advantage.
Chef Michael is actually spitting out a lot of information about using cayenne pepper. Like, he knows what he's doing. He's talking the game.
I'm using canned products on purpose. The reality is Meg doesn't have time to go pick peas and boil them.
The canned peas I find to be an interesting call with such a bounty of fresh.
They generally taste like canned peas and samosas. I always wish that they were a little bit more fresh.
We have to make it so she really can do it, because I don't want to waste my time with people who can't change.
Oh my God. I hate cooking under the clock. The clock is ticking, ticking, ticking away. I'm feeling the pressure. I'm concerned. I don't know if I'm gonna get my dish done. As I'm putting this dish together, I'm gonna keep those Indian spices with just a little shred of cheese because that's what a quesadilla is. I know Meg can recreate this at home, and I hope she's gonna be satisfied with it.
Baking sheets right in front of me. Meg loves the Indian samosa because it's creamy on the inside and crunchy on the outside. I'm pureeing my vegetables. Once it's out of the food processor, I start to place it inside my wonton wrappers. I gotta get these things in the oven, get them to start baking. They need probably about 9 minutes or so. And then I look up at the clock. There's about 7 minutes left. I think I may have sabotaged myself.
And you walked back?
For our first competitive cooking round, our chefs have 20 minutes to make a healthy version of an Indian samosa for Meg, who is struggling with Lyme disease.
Time's starting to tick away.
I have got to get my wonton dumplings in the oven, and hopefully they will bake in time.
There's not that much time left. He's got to bake those, which is going to take longer than frying them.
$3.40, guys. $3.40.
So
I pull my wontons out, and they're brown on the edges, but they're not browning on the top. They're not really crisp. My wonton isn't crunchy, so I'm going to pick it up and add that texture with some whole pomegranate seeds.
It's going to cut it close for sure, is Michael. Less than a minute, chefs. Less than a minute.
Oh, my God, what did I do?
Down to the wire.
All right, chefs, 10 seconds left. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Stop cooking. Hands up.
Time's up, and my samosas are not really crispy, so I'm a little disappointed about my dish.
So, chefs, it's time for our panel of experts to taste your version of Meg's favorite snack, Indian samosas. The original was loaded with saturated fat and refined carbs. Let's see how your new and improved snacks stand up to the original. Ariane, you're up first.
My heart's beating, my hands are sweating. I really hope Meg sees this snack as a healthy, family-friendly alternative.
So what I've created for you today is a samosa-inspired quesadilla. However, instead of potato, I used cauliflower with a little chili, a little onion, cumin, to keep that flavor that you're looking for. I have battled with weight all my life, but it's always been a struggle for me. So learning how to eat our favorite foods and kind of making them taste great and satisfying is really important to me.
All right, so Meg, what do you think about this?
I like the quesadilla idea because it's easy to pick up and it does translate to my son well.
Great. I just think the concept of using the cauliflower instead of the potato was brilliant, and I think you were really inspired by her samosa. Cauliflower is a cruciferous vegetable loaded with antioxidants, will be good as an anti-inflammatory for Meg. So overall, really good job.
I just love that you use the word cruciferous vegetable.
Cruciferous.
This is the type of recipe that you can find on upwave.com that you can make at home. Less than 20 minutes, obviously.
Last question for you, sorry, the tortilla. What type of tortilla
did you
use?
It's a flour. It's a flour, yeah.
Was it a whole wheat flour tortilla?
I was looking for them. I didn't see them.
White flour is full of refined carbohydrates, not a great source of energy for Meg.
Chef Michael, you're up next.
Let's start at the bottom of the plate first. It is a mango pomegranate dipping sauce. On top of that is a dumpling of pan-seared vegetables. On top are the pomegranates. I toss those with a little bit of cinnamon and cayenne pepper.
I know my wontons did not crisp up enough at this point after I took them out of the oven. I just hope my flavors can make up for it.
Clearly, you know your stuff, man.
Thank you.
You know your stuff. And I do think that it ended up being the right proportion of nutrients as far as protein, fat, and carbohydrates for a snack. And it looks like a lot because it's three pieces. So I like that.
The wrapper is not quite there. Something is amiss, and I cannot put my finger on it.
Well, Meg, you can't put your finger on it, but I will.
Okay.
The wonton wrapper is undercooked, and it doesn't have that nice, crispy, crunchy flavor because you ran out of time.
In round one, I feel I'm off my game. I don't think I'm impressing the judges enough right now. I'm getting a little bit of anxiety.
Chef Gina, you're up next. Why don't you tell Meg and the panel what you made today?
You have a open-faced whole wheat bruschetta samosa. The deal is that this is about you changing, and that change starts with this meal right here. I change people, and I want to change you. And if you commit to me, I will commit to you.
Thank you.
I'm listening to Gina. She's very passionate. I got a little nervous.
I might feel a little rough. That's how I work. But at the end of the day, I really care, and I commit to people. I will be there till the end, right?
Meg, the question is, are you buying it?
I like the topping, but I will say that I am not a fan of canned peas. They're kind of like holding me back just a little bit.
Well, let me say this. We have to be realistic. What you've been doing is not working, Meg. You may not love them, but we can work with it. So I defend those peas. When I saw you cooking, I was thinking, oh girl, you are going way overboard with the carbs there. I chose elements like potatoes because that's what Meg likes. I was actually complimenting you that I thought.
I'm unnecessarily fighting you.
It's okay.
All right, chefs, so now our judges are going to deliberate and see who blew away this round and is going to get an advantage heading into the second round. So you can retire to the pantry. So judges, with taking into consideration taste, creativity, and nutrition, what do you think?
I love that Gina was really using her nutritionist, dietitian mind.
I had a problem with the peas, but at the same time, delicious.
I thought of it more like a boot camp instructor presentation.
You need someone who's going to be tough.
It might be over the top, though, yeah.
It's hard because people have an idea of what they would do, but then that's really probably not what they would do. So she's like, I would use fresh peas. And I'm like, you don't even make the samosas. You just buy them.
Arian's dish, technically proficient. Everything was prepared well. And also, it was green and orange and white and red and visually appealing.
Arian's biggest mistake was using that white flour tortilla. We want to get you away from those refined carbohydrates. So that was a big mistake.
Michael's filling might have been the most flavorful thing that was from any of the contestants.
I agree with you. I think his filling was great. I really like the flavor of the pomegranate.
I would have liked to have tried Michael's with the proper baking.
If Michael would have fixed those few flaws, he would have been one of the top contenders here.
He knows a lot about nutrition, and he really is going to consider your health.
Meg, this is for you. Do we have a decision?
I think so.
Round one tasting is done, and I feel pretty good. My only concern is that Meg may not be ready to make a change.
All right, chefs. The three of you are competing to help Meg achieve her weight loss goals. Your challenge in the first round was to make an awesome alternative to one of Meg's favorite snacks, the Indian samosa. With taking into consideration taste, creativity, and of course, nutrition, our judges have made a decision. The winner of the snack attack round is Chef Arian. Nice little jump, by the way. So, Chef Nate, why did the judges decide that Arian's was the best dish in the first round?
You updated the samosa, but you chose to use the right ingredients to not weigh it down.
I think it was great all around.
Thank you.
So, Chef Arian, you won the first round, which means you're going to get a huge advantage heading into the second round that I'm going to tell you about in a little bit. But first, let's get to round two, where somebody will be going home. Meg, what is that one dish that you just crave, you keep going back to it time and time again? You know it's maybe not the best for you, but you just love it.
It is a grilled cheese sandwich.
The double-decker grilled cheese sandwich.
Is that a triple?
Crunchy, ooey, gooey, comforting food, an American classic. What's not to love, Keri?
First of all, loaded with calories, loaded with fat. I don't mind a little bit of good cheese here and now. I mean, cheese, it's a source of protein, source of calcium, especially for Meg as a vegetarian. It's a way for her to get in some protein. Too much saturated fat, though, for her here, because that will increase the inflammation in her body, and she does have Lyme disease.
So, Chef Arian, since you dominated the competition in the first round, you're going to run downstairs to the pantry and pick one of three ingredients that your competitors must use in this round.
Okay.
Don't hold it against me.
We're giving Arian three twist ingredients to choose from. Ghost chilies, one of the hottest chilies in the world, a whole coconut, or an ostrich egg.
Oh my goodness, this ostrich egg, it's just huge, and what are they gonna do with it?
Well, you brought a box.
I definitely think this will trip them up a little bit.
All right, chef, ready to reveal? Ostrich eggs.
They're yours.
This can go either way, guys. There's a lot of protein in there, but there's also a lot of fat and calories. So this is gonna be a tricky ingredient. Chefs, you got 30 minutes on the clock. Are you ready?
Ready.
All right, go cook your ass off.
For my grilled cheese sandwich, I'm gonna choose products that were really delicious and that have that sort of creamy texture that you get from a grilled cheese,
but are also loaded with the nutrients Meg needs.
And I'm using avocado with a little bit of provolone and our whole wheat bread.
Hi, Gina, how are you?
I'm good.
How are you cutting the calories and making this a little bit more healthier for Meg?
First of all, we'll see how we're portioning this differently.
Yes.
And we're using a whole wheat toast here. I made the portion size smaller by changing the shape of the product. And I'm gonna be using the ostrich egg as a batter because it's loaded with vitamins.
Yeah, good luck.
Thank you.
Oh no.
Ooh. Did they just break an egg?
Catch. Wow. That was close.
One of the worst things about grilled cheese is all the empty carbs. So I want to give Meg an open-faced sandwich with feta cheese and brown rice bread.
The unfamiliarity of the ostrich eggs threw me for a loop.
Chef Michael's getting ready to get his open.
Okay, let's check this out.
So I used an egg as a batter coating. It's dense, has a nice texture. The batter's going to soften the bread up a little bit, and still I'm thinking I'm going to get some crunch out of it also.
You have to remember also that the ostrich egg is also going to have the vitamin A and D in that yolk. You don't find vitamin D in many foods.
What I learned from the first round about Meg is that she likes simple food that's easy to make at home, and that's what I do. And I feel I got this because I got kids and they love grilled cheese. So I'm choosing the smoked cheddar because it's so flavorful, a little bit goes a long way, which means less calories.
I am cooking with feta cheese because the type I use is a goat's cheese, and goat's milk is very high in alpha-lipoic acid. That helps burn fat, helps lower cholesterol. It has no saturated fat in it whatsoever. And I'm gonna grill the feta cheese and try to get some char marks.
I'd love to see someone use cheese as the base of a sandwich and maybe put vegetables in the middle.
You know, I like your idea. It's taking the literal sense of grilled cheese.
Yeah.
It's actually the cheese itself is cooked.
Chef's 13 minutes left.
Michael, I think, something happened there. I'm not sure what Chef Michael just did. He put the cheese on the grill for about 20 seconds and then took it off. I'm not sure if that qualifies as grilled cheese.
My cheese is melting on the grill quicker than it's getting char marks on it. So my plan is now to just go back to a traditional grilled cheese.
I think he just took a left turn.
Somewhere. Oh, because he's putting the cheese in the middle. Oh, I still want that cheese on the grill.
Time's starting to tick. I had to get that bread in the pan to get that cheese melted at this point.
I don't know the terms and all the nutritional names of everything. However, I know food. I know flavors. And I know simplicity. It's important.
I'm making a side of tomato soup.
It's fresh, simple, and doesn't have the fats or sodium of canned soup. So I know Meg is gonna love it.
10 and a half minutes.
Woo!
Toasty, right?
Just a little.
I have to get these sandwiches assembled and in the pan with enough time to crisp up.
Oh, she's dunking it.
Wow, now that's a lot of egg.
Right now, I'm trying to achieve a really delicious, grilled, crispy whole wheat slice. But it isn't working.
Gina just grabbed another pot, sort of gave it the old panini smash sort of press, the smash press, which is a good idea.
Whatever she's doing, doesn't look like it's working.
Oh, guys, check this out. The burner's not on.
That's gonna present a problem.
Oh, yes. That's definitely an issue. Chefs, you have 2.5 minutes to finish your healthy interpretations of Meg's grilled cheese.
So I was having a couple problems with searing off my grilled cheese. And time is ticking down, and I have to plate.
You can tell here one of the challenges getting that browning on the bread.
You know, opposed to Michael right now, he has his bread is toasted, but his cheese looks really hard and not gooey.
I realized my cheese is not ooey gooey.
I hope switching from an open-faced grilled cheese wasn't a mistake.
Less than a minute, chefs. Less than a minute.
If I go home in this round, of course I will be disappointed because I feel like grilled cheese is very simple. And I want to give her inspiration and idea that she can do this.
Chefs, less than 30 seconds left, chefs.
I'm in my zone right now. Somebody's going home. And I'm, you know, feeling the pressure.
These challenges are crazy.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Stop cooking. Stop.
Time's up, and I'm so nervous. I didn't have a crispy whole wheat slice, but I hope the judges really love my dish.
So, chefs, you've all created a meal makeover for Meg's favorite meal, a grilled cheese sandwich. Even though this classic comfort food satisfied Meg, it was loaded with the unhealthy fats and carbs that are making her Lyme disease even worse. Chef Michael, tell us what you did as an alternative to Meg's grilled cheese.
Okay, I did a brown rice bread grilled cheese, sort of like take on a croque madame or a Monte Cristo. I battered the bread in the ostrich egg. I hope you enjoy.
So Meg, how does this stack up?
Well, I would like the cheese to be just a little more melted.
Yeah. You know, I looked at it and thought that cheese is just going to be rock hard. And it's not ooey gooey and melty, but it had a nice softness to it.
So, Nate, did Chef Michael really utilize the egg?
Yeah, you put the egg on there as well, kind of like the Monte Cristo you talked about. Good idea.
I like the flavor. I love the cheese choice. It's lower in calories and fat than most traditional cheeses, so I think that was a great choice. The one thing I'd say is maybe you could have even done it open face. Richard actually mentioned that before. He was thinking that somebody was going to do an open face sandwich.
Oh, I should have stuck with my original plan.
Chef Gina, tell us what you made as a makeover for Meg's grilled cheese.
I have a bright brunch grilled cheese with provolone, and then we also have avocado in there because we want that richness. You can also see that I've cut off the ends there. That's about portion size. I want you to enjoy that grilled cheese and I want you to love it, but I want you to have the right amount.
The ostrich egg, how did you incorporate that into the dish?
Well, I did a similar thing, you know, dipping. It was in and out though, so you really kind of have just an outside layer, and I think it's actually really nice.
Overall, you've got the right proportion of your carbohydrates to your protein to your fat. It's a really nice balanced vegetarian meal.
I love the idea of like being able to capture that gooiness with the avocado. Just awesome.
To me, it had more of a consistency of quiche. So I think I would have liked it to be a little bit more crisp.
You achieved the gooiness, but you lost the crisp.
All right, Chef Ariane.
Okay, so what I've prepared is a smoked cheddar, chili pear, grilled cheese with a little sauteed kale. On the side, you have a fresh tomato oregano soup. I honestly can say I don't know all the terms and words, but I want you to be able to take a simple grilled cheese, add stuff to it, so you elevate it, it tastes great, you're satisfied, and then you have the fresh soup on the side.
I have to dunk it.
I don't. On the surface, I looked at this and thought, boring. And then I saw the kale inside. And then I tasted the smoked cheese. And there is nothing boring about this.
Love the use of the kale in there. Kale is loaded with omega-3s and vitamin K, two nutrients which both can help fight inflammation.
And I can tell that you're a mom because you snuck in kale without really knowing.
All right, so Meg, is this a grilled cheese that you'd make at home?
As a vegetarian, I don't care for the flavor of meat. And so the smoked cheese has that flavor that I tend to
stay away from. Okay.
But I can see how it can easily be replaced.
Okay.
All right, chefs, thank you so much. We can head back to the pantry while the judges hash out the deliberation.
I am feeling a little nervous because the fact that I reminded her of meat is something I didn't want to do at all. The smoked cheddar could be my ticket home.
So judges, really big decision here because someone's going home, someone's getting eliminated. We'll start, Meg, with your thoughts on Michael's dish.
I enjoyed the flavors. I enjoyed the Mediterranean flavors. The cheese was maybe a little on the dry side for me.
The cheese for me was actually soft and gooey, and I looked at it and thought, that's going to be hard. And his choice of the brown rice bread, it was great.
It was a great choice.
Yeah,
I liked that.
Choice. And then dipping it with egg for a little bit more protein.
From a nutrition perspective, I love that he's thinking about every single nutrient going into it and how what it does for the body.
All right, so Chef Gina. Chef Gina, she's intense.
Her food isn't that over the top,
no.
Like crazy intense.
No.
It's actually
just
quite
the opposite. She did the job. She made it over. She had the vegetarian protein. She got in healthy fats. She got in all the right nutrients in the right portions. I wasn't so excited to dive into that plate.
I appreciate her energy and what she has to bring to the table. She seems to have a real knowledge base. The flavors of the dish weren't popping for me.
Right.
So to work with a strong personality and not be getting the spices that I may be looking for is something that I take into consideration.
You know, one of us is leaving now and I think there's a lot at stake in this round.
Chef Ariane.
Soup on its own, it's a throwaway. Dunking the sandwich in, it definitely took it to another place.
I liked the concept, I liked where she was going. Having that soup does fill you up. And it is a great tool for people when they're trying to lose weight.
Well, I think the only issue you had is that she hates meat.
That
she specifically
smoke, yeah.
Said she hates the smokiness.
I mean, I guess I did think of the bacon aspect, but I didn't think that she would dislike
really
it that much.
So judges, unfortunately, we have to send someone home in this competition right now in this round. Do we have a decision?
We have a decision.
Yeah. All right, chefs. We're here today to find the right chef that will guide and mentor Meg so that she can get back to a healthier lifestyle. But there's only room for two chefs in our third and final round.
I'm definitely concerned. The smoked cheddar could be my ticket home.
Chef Michael, you're staying.
Thank you.
And so are you, Chef Ariane. Unfortunately, Chef Gina, that means you've been eliminated.
It's okay. I want to say thank you so much for this opportunity. And I'm sort of excited that you're about to change. I think it's great, and I wish you all the luck in the world.
Gina, I really appreciate what you bring to the table. You really thought about what I wanted. Unfortunately, it just wasn't a fit with me.
Chef Gina, thank you so much for your effort today. Good luck.
Thank you. I'm feeling a little frustrated. I feel like all my meals were really, really on target. But I am proud of Meg because this is a first step for her.
Chef Ariane, Chef Michael, congratulations. You've advanced to the final round of Cook Your Ass Off. All right, chefs. Meg's biggest challenge is making meals that will give her the nutrients she needs to fight Lyme disease, but at the same time satisfy her whole family. So your final challenge is to create the ideal dinner that both Meg and her son can enjoy. You're gonna have 30 minutes on the clock, but we're not gonna make it that easy. We're gonna give you two ingredients that you must include in your dinner meal. Chefs, are you ready? Garbanzo beans and kohlrabi.
You kidding, really?
I'm most worried about using kohlrabi. It's a vegetable that we don't use too often.
And Keri, why did we choose these ingredients?
We chose the garbanzo beans because Meg is a vegetarian, so she needs to get her protein from plant sources. Then the kohlrabi is part of the cabbage family, which you probably both know, also loaded with antioxidants, and I think it could be a great part of a dinner for her.
All right, chefs, are you ready to show us what you got?
Ready. Definitely. Ready, ready.
Now go cook your ass off!
I know this is a competition. I know there's a lot at stake, but I relate to Meg in so many different ways, and I know I would be great with her. We would be a great team. No ifs, ands, or buts. God. So I decided to make a quinoa fried rice, skipping the frying part, but adding broccoli, bok choy, the chickpeas, a little bit of chili, scallion, and then finishing it with a nice slaw of the kohlrabi. So the quinoa is going to take the longest, so that's what I start first.
So Ariane has busted out the ingredient that I know Keri loves, quinoa.
Quinoa is actually a seed, not a grain. It's a super seed. It's high in protein, where really that's hard to get in plant-based protein, so it's a great item to add to your pantry.
I'm not gonna play it safe in round three at all. It's a $50,000 prize that I'm looking at in front of me, so I'm gonna go outside the box and maybe go a little extreme with some of the things I'm gonna make, and hopefully it's gonna get me there.
So I'm going to make a smoked hummus with sauteed kohlrabi and vegetables. It's a light, healthy vegetarian dish with a lot of protein for Meg.
I'm going to substitute hummus as the base of my plate because she actually likes potatoes and it's just not good for her to have. So instead of a mashed potato, I'm going to do a hummus and leave it a little thicker so I can get that consistency as she feels like maybe she's eating a potato.
Judges, Chef Michael has the cannellini beans and it looks like some pepper in the food processor there. Hummus, maybe?
I hope he's not just doing a straightforward hummus. I hope he's doing something else.
With Lyme disease, I mean, she's prone to have flare-ups, so anything that has capsaicin in there, it actually will deaden the nerves and actually give some pain relief. So right now, I think I'm hitting a home run.
All right, chefs, 15 minutes left.
I am definitely feeling the pressure. I know that Mike knows all this nutritional value. However, I don't want Meg to go home and think that this is how she has to cook to live and to be healthy. I want her to know that just adding a few different ingredients and just maybe blanching the broccoli and throwing in a whole garbanzo bean, that's okay.
You know, I'm looking over at Chef Ariana. She didn't even do anything with the kohlrabi, but just slice it down. I know she wanted that crunch in there, but I think it should have been implemented in different ways.
Yeah. I shaved and kept the kohlrabi raw because it still has that crunch. It has all the nutrition. I haven't taken anything out of it.
She's really not going too outside of the box. She stayed really, really basic, but you got to focus on yourself. Focus on myself, and I focused on my client. So I also have to make a balsamic vinegar reduction with some dates in there. Okay, the dish needs the sweetness because of the smokiness in the hummus and also the bitterness of the kohlrabi.
lots of antioxidants in dates as well. And they're so sweet that you just need a little bit to really satisfy that sweet craving.
Chefs, only 3 minutes left. You gotta get your food on the plates.
Toast, toast, toast.
Feeling the pressure of the clock, I don't think I'm gonna finish.
Ariane, the smile is gone. This is now intense focus.
My head starts spinning. There's a lot at stake. And I know, in the back of my head, I know it's there.
Chefs, 30 seconds, you gotta plate the food.
I'm trying to get my food on the plate. I'm starting to get sloppy.
There goes presentation.
You know, I might seem calm on the outside, but like I'm jumping on the inside. I think my hands were even shaking as I was putting my sauce on the plate.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, stop cooking.
I really think I hit this challenge head on. I hope the judges really recognize how I transformed the ingredients and how I went to that next level.
I look over and I see Mike's dish and I'm like, wow, it's beautiful. The colors are just bursting. Yeah, I'm sweating a little bit because I know Mike's dish looks like he nailed it.
All right, so chefs, for your final challenge, you were asked to create the ideal dinner for Meg and her son. Let's see who made the best use of the two special ingredients, garbanzo beans and kohlrabi. Chef Ariane, tell us about the dish you prepared.
I prepared quinoa-style fried rice, I call it. A lot of protein in the quinoa instead of rice. You got the chickpeas. And then I finished it with the kohlrabi salad, just fresh, shaved, a little bit of chili sesame, and fresh mint to really brighten it up.
All right, Keri.
This is just a bowl of wonderful, nutritious ingredients.
You know, I thought it was a stroke of brilliance to have the green onions almost raw. Because of my family, my son will not touch a dish with onions. And so here it is, they're separate.
It has a nice spice to it.
The spice,
yeah, that was
great.
For you.
I love the tang. It's immediate too, yeah. Like you put it in and yum.
The only thing I could say would be you could have gotten a little bit more creative with the chickpeas and the kohlrabi.
And I'm like, oh no, I didn't repurpose the garbanzo beans.
You know what I love about this, judges? This is the type of recipe that any parent can go to upwave.com. It's something they could easily cook at home for themselves. Thank you, Chef Ariane. Chef Michael, why don't you tell the panel of judges what you've made today?
I did a smoked paprika, garbanzo bean, hummus, and I pan-seared some kohlrabi. And then lastly, we have a balsamic vinegar reduction with some dates in there.
From the hummus to the kohlrabi, this is so packed full of flavor.
I love the vegetables that you brought to the dish, but the smoked pepper brings a flavor that brings that hint of meat.
Smoked? Didn't you learn from my mistake?
I just think of this as maybe a dip or even a component of a meal. That's my one criticism.
Thank you, chefs. I think you've gave our judges a really difficult job ahead of them.
Final tasting is over. This is it. One of us is going to win, and I'm praying that it's me.
Let's compare these two dishes.
Ariane's hit all of the nutritional components that I wanted. Michael was absolutely more creative.
Nate, did Ariane do enough, though, to the kohlrabi and the chickpeas?
No, absolutely not.
See, I didn't transform anything, and I don't know if that's gonna really hurt me.
Two totally different people, completely different backgrounds. Who do you think's gonna be best for you?
It's a tough decision for me. I see that Michael knows how to bring somebody along as far as the nutrition goes. Ariane, her flavors I tend to favor.
I can see her there educating you and cooking with you and your son. On the other hand, I can also see Michael really making over your life.
We're like neck and neck right now.
Yeah, I think so too.
Right now.
So judges, do we have a decision?
I think we do.
All right, let's get the chefs back out.
My heart is like through my chest right now.
Chefs, both of you have made it through three intense cook your ass off rounds, but only one has secured a place to help Meg get on a healthy cooking and eating plan. That same chef will also earn the opportunity to come back in the next round of our tournament and earn the chance to win $50,000. Chef Michael. I'm sorry, but you will not be moving on to the next round of our tournament.
You can't imagine how you guys made me feel today with the compliments, and finally that I
got my nutrition out there.
You did a phenomenal job.
Thank you.
You know, you made health food and vegetarian food so flavorful that I'm a believer.
Well, Chef Michael, best of luck. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. I think I had the best culinary point of view as far as nutrition. So, you know, mission accomplished on that end on my behalf.
Chef Ariane, congratulations, you've won.
A bigger jump this time.
Thank you.
So excited.
Meg, we're going to be great girlfriends. I want to take the journey with you. I'm excited to do it with you together.
I think it'll be awesome. I'm looking forward to it.
So, Chef Ariane, congratulations. You've won the chance to help Meg and the opportunity to win $50,000.
I'm really happy. I'm proud of myself.